All right, folks, we're back with this beautiful golden red snapper from New Zealand. And this is right where we left off. So what I did is I got a stick of butter. I'm not going to use a whole stick. I'm only going to use 3/4 of a tablespoon of butter. So this nice little dollop, we'll call it, of butter. And I have a pan that I put on the fire just now. What I'm going to do, you don't want it too hot, but you want it hot enough to where you can, cook your fish. So now whenever you put it in and then it's a little too hot and you burn your butter, that's when you know your pan's too hot. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to cool the pan down a little bit. Just that simple, folks. Butter burns quickly and easily. Now I've got that. I put my butter in the pan now and it's not burning. It's melting nicely. Just to show you guys, cooking is experimenting. If you try one thing and it doesn't work, then you don't be afraid to try something else. And if it starts out not so bad, now this is what you want. See, the butter's not burning. I have my piece of golden red snapper from New Zealand. And I'm just gonna saute it because I wanna see. And it's not the healthiest way to eat it, but most of the butter's gonna stay in the pan. And I have my flame on medium, a little less than medium, because it's gonna, and this is all real time, folks. This is how we're gonna try it this way. I've never cooked it before, but by doing this, I can gauge how much flavor or seasoning I'm gonna have to put in. There's a little Himalayan salt. I'll put a little sprinkle on that one side, and you're only gonna have to turn this fish over once, folks. You know, now while the fish is in there and it's cooking, the butter's gonna brown a little. If you want to, you can add, to slow down the burning of the butter, you can add a little bit of olive oil, and that's not gonna hurt it any. That's gonna just slow down that butter from turning too dark. But you know, that's beautiful. That's exactly the way that you want it to look. All right, so I've got a stainless steel pan, so it's okay if you use metal spatulas on it, because there's nothing to scrape off. It's not a Teflon. If it was a Teflon, which I don't use, I don't really like Teflon, because after a while you see the pieces come off, more than likely they've been scraped off and you're eating them with your food, so it's not very healthy. But see how beautiful that looks? There's no breading, no seasoning, just a little bit of salt. When I flip it, I'll put a little more salt on the other side, so we can flip that. It's even got a nice brown color. That's beautiful. That is beautiful. Put it just a touch more salt. And then we're gonna let it finish cooking just like that. In fact, I'm gonna turn my fire down even more, because the butter's hot enough. It's a delicate fish. It has a lot of flavor. We tried it out raw and it came out really, really nice. So now we're gonna go ahead and see what it tastes like when we cook it. And this way, you can see how heavily you have to season it, if any, when you're cooking it, if you're going to batter it and fry it, if you're going to saute it. Now, this is how you gauge how much flavor you need to add, because you don't want to be robbed of the natural flavor of the fish. Now, a lot of people may say, well, how do I know if this fish is ready to eat yet? You know, how do you know if it's cooked on the inside? Well, my answer to you is, don't be afraid to take the thickest part, which is the center right here, and just go ahead and cut it in half so that you can look at the center. If it's white all the way through, folks, just like that, that means that it's cooked. It's ready to go. So I'm gonna turn my fire off. Let it swirl around a little more. See the butter still in the pan? So you're not really eating that butter. I mean, it seemed like it was a lot of butter, but you're not really eating it. So before I even put any lemon or anything on it, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna taste it, and then I'm gonna let my camera woman taste it. So this is the belly part, the Toro. So this is a fatty fish, so the belly part's gonna be really nice. So what I'll do is I'll go ahead and try this piece first. Let it cool. Wow, folks, it has a taste that is absolutely amazing. Folks, listen. You don't have to season this fish. This fish has such a sweet, it's almost a mixture between scallops and shrimp. This fish is amazing, folks. This golden red snapper from New Zealand. Listen, I'm gonna let my camera woman taste this. And listen, when you cut out your bones and everything, when you're cooking, and if you see any other bones, like I can see that little bone right there, that must have been one that we missed. Well, we're gonna let her taste this and let her tell you what she thinks about this. Go ahead and...
Oh, that's really good. It's not fishy or anything.
It's not one little bit fishy. It's amazing.
Mm.
Folks, I recommend if this gets a double thumbs up, I am definitely gonna, if I see it again, I'm gonna definitely buy it. You guys can see that it's beautiful. It's beautifully cooked all the way through, and it only took a couple of minutes.
It's really good.
Oh my goodness. I think I found one of my new favorite fish. Oh wow.
That is really good.
Would you like another taste?
Yes, thank you.
That is just phenomenal. I gotta tell you.
It just melts in your mouth.
It melts in your mouth. No heavy cooking. It didn't take anything to cook this. It cooked literally a minute and a minute and a half on each side.
Oh wow. That's really
good. That is delicious. Here's how it looks. And when you guys finish cooking it the way that I showed you to, this is how the plate's gonna look. Wow, folks, that is amazing. So if you guys have any comments that you'd like to share with us, don't be afraid. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you guys for tuning in. This is Chef Pep, and it's bye for now.